Do you believe everything you hear about diabetes on YouTube? I hope not. Welcome to Diabetes Every Day. Please remember to tap the subscribe button and sign up for my newsletter on diabeteseveryday.com for science-based, credible information about managing diabetes. I've been seeing a series of videos on YouTube about what foods spike your blood sugar, but there's a lot more to the story than what's being portrayed. Unfortunately, they don't share the science or the research and are just throwing information out that you may want to hear. The science gives us answers. So, in today's video, I'm going to dispel the myths or things you may be hearing. Is it fact or fiction? Let's review the reasons behind some of these food and blood sugar spike claims. Banana versus a chocolate candy bar. What do you want to hear? My guess is that you'd love to see that a candy bar won't raise your blood sugar as much as fruit. Well, here are the facts. We wouldn't expect that the candy bar will bring up our blood sugar as much as a banana initially. As a reminder, we want our blood sugar to be between 80 and 130 before a meal and 180 or less 2 hours after the start of eating. This information is science-based. It comes from the latest American Diabetes Association position paper, which reviews the latest research. To come up with these target ranges, they are looking for the suggested blood sugar range to prevent complications from diabetes. After all, that's what we all want. We are managing our blood sugar to prevent any complications from diabetes and feel well. So, that's our overall goal. Oh, and one other important piece of information. Checking blood sugar of people who aren't diagnosed with diabetes is not information that's comparable. Through lots of research, we also have answers on what combination of foods or elements in foods will slow down the absorption of carbohydrate to prevent spikes in blood sugar readings. So, in the case of a healthy food choice like a piece of fresh fruit, what we need to look at is the portion size. A 4-ounce banana, in this case, is equal to a 15-gram portion. And we need to consider how much nutrition a piece of fruit offers, like it's a great source of potassium. The amount of protein, fat, and fiber for this portion of a banana is negligible. And protein, fat, and fiber help slow down the absorption of carbohydrate consumption. So we may see a higher reading initially, and as a dietitian, I always recommend consuming foods like this with another food that will have protein or fiber or fat to help slow down the carb absorption. So for a milk chocolate candy bar, well, there's a whole lot of calories, fat, saturated fat, and carbohydrate. The high fat content of the candy bar helps slow down the absorption of carbohydrate, but doesn't help with any of the negative parts like lots of added calories, added sugar, and saturated fat that will raise our risk for heart disease. No thank you. And note, depending on your level of insulin sensitivity, it's very possible that your blood sugar will spike, but it will be later in the day. When we are looking at our food choices, always look at the whole picture instead of looking at only one part of the equation. Remember, we want to manage our overall health, which includes managing our blood sugar. Thanks for watching. Until next time, cheers to your health.